All right, Math 8. This is your Wednesday homework, yep, okay? All right, so let's look at this. To reflect or reflection is to flip, okay? It's to flip. So reflection is to flip. So we're either going to flip it over the x-axis, over the y-axis, okay? We're either going to flip it over the x or over the y. So what that means is this, okay? If it's over the x-axis, I'm going to trace over the x. So whatever points are above the x-axis is going to be below. And whatever points are below the x-axis is going to be above. So let's do this. You see where L is? L is above the x-axis. So when I flip it, it's going to be below. How much below? If I use this as my line of reflection, then since L is 2 above the line, it's going to be 2 under the line. This is my new location for L. This is now L prime. The tick mark means that L has moved one time, one transformation. G is 1, 2, 3, 4 above the line. So when you flip G over the line of reflection, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 below. So this is also G prime. Okay. All right. So now Q is one below the line. So when I flip it, it needs to be, it's going to be one above the line. So this is now Q prime. So I'm going to connect my points, and you can see that it is flipped. Okay, it's flipped. Went from here down here. Okay. All right, so let's try the next one. This time we're going to flip it over the Y. So now I'm going to flip it this way. I'm going to trace the Y-axis. This is my line of reflection. So I'm going to flip it over the Y. Y is going to stay right where it is because it's on the line of reflection. So I'm going to just put Y prime right beside it. Okay. When I flip T, you see T is 1, 2, 3, 4 away from the line of reflection. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 on this side of the line of reflection. This is T prime. I is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 away from the line of reflection. So when I flip it over here, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the other side. So I'm going to connect. And as you can see, it flipped over the line of reflection. Okay, this where there's no tick marks is the pre-image before the move. Where you see a tick mark, this is after the move. It's moved one time. This is my image. Pre-image on the top. Sorry. Image where it flipped over the line of reflection is on the bottom. Okay? All right, so let's do this one. So now we have to graph the ordered pairs and then flip it over the x-axis, okay? So we graph this x-coordinate, y-coordinate, x-coordinate, y-coordinate, x-coordinate, y-coordinate, okay? So negative one on the x, on the x-axis. This is, let me make it just a little bit darker, okay? Okay? Negative one on the x-axis is to the left one time from the origin. Negative five is down five. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is H. Okay? We got negative one again, one to the left and down. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is M. We got one on the x, one over to the right, and down 1, 2. This is B. And positive three and negative three. 1, 2, 3. I'm sorry. Positive, yeah, that's it right. Down 1, 2, and 3. So now we're going to flip it over to X. I'm going to make the X-axis just a little bit more darker. This is the line that I want to flip it over. Okay? All right.
So now let's flip it over that line.
Let's start with B. B is below the line, 2 below the line. So when you flip it, it's going to be 2 above. This is B prime. C is 1, 2, 3 below the line. So when you flip it, it's going to be 1, 2, 3 above the line. This is C prime. M is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 below the line. So when I flip it, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 above the line. This is M prime. And H is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 below. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 above the line. This is H prime. So you connect. And as you can see, it flipped over the x-axis, okay? Without the tick marks, this is where it started. This is my pre-image where it flipped, where it landed after the transformation is my image. Okay? This is after the move. Before, after, okay? All right, y'all. If you have any more questions, see me in the morning. Bye.